Appalachian Wireless has some of the best data rates in wireless on our plans, and not to mention an amazing deal on one of our hottest smartphones. But that's all the time I have to explain. See store for details. Better service, bigger savings. That's today's Appalachian Wireless.
At this time, I would like to make a motion that we challenge the legality on the vote of the Commissioner of Former Governor.
That was the Pike County Fiscal Court's March 21st meeting. This week, the court moved forward on that action. On Wednesday, Assistant County Attorney John Doug Hayes filed suit in Pike Circuit Court seeking a declaratory judgment to either declare invalid the petition that led to the ultimately successful vote to change the county's government from magistrate-based to a commissioner form of government, or to declare the petition legal. In the filing, Hayes argues that the petition does not meet the requirements of Kentucky law to add the measure to the ballot because the required 1,200 signatures were achieved by combining two different petitions, one from 2015 that was declared insufficient, and one from 2016. Hayes, in the filing, is asking the court to determine whether the petition is valid or invalid. Greg Blankenship, who heads up the group responsible for the commissioner vote effort, Pike Countyans Against Government Waste, said the lawsuit does not seek clarification on the legality of the petition. Instead, he said, it seeks only to infringe on the will of the people.
It's something that transcends whether you're for or against a commissioner form of government, as the question clearly stated. It's now a question of, are they going to willingly be peaceful about this? And I think we got our answer the other day, and that answer is no. For our elected officials who have a vested interest in the outcome of this election, clearly, to sue, to overturn the will of the people, it's irresponsible, it's unethical, it's downright wrong.
Blankenship said Ray Jones has taken on the case to represent those who want to challenge the fiscal court member's filing.
It's a sad day in this country that we have to do it. That they're not willing to have a peaceful transfer of government in this county. That they want to invalidate the will of the people. But that's up to them, and they made their decision, and I hope that they will be satisfied with the outcome, because the people definitely are not. They want change, they got it.
No court dates have been scheduled yet in the case. Reporting in Pikeville for EKB News, I'm Chris Anderson.